The Empress Xiao Jin was Wang Shi. Her last name was Wang, and the first name disappeared in the history. She was the imperial noble consort of the Emperor Wan Li, and was posthumously promoted to the Empress when her son became the Emperor. In 1577, the Empress Dowager Xiao An and the Empress Dowager Xiao Ding held an election event to choose one empress and two consorts for Wan Li. About 450 girls joined this event. Wang Shi didn't go to the final round, but because she was pretty, the Empress Dowager Xiao Ding kept her as a maid. In 1581, Wan Li visited the Empress Dowager Xiao Ding and met Wang Shi by chance. Wan Li was suddenly attracted by this beautiful girl and had a relationship with her. According to Ming Dynasty inner court rules, after the emperor had a relationship with a court lady, he should give this lady a gift as proof. Wan Li didn't give Wang Shi any gift because he tried to hide their relationship. Unfortunately, Wang Shi was pregnant and was found by the Empress Dowager Xiao Ding. The Empress Dowager asked Wan Li the truth. Wan Li denied. Fortunately, in Ming Dynasty, the Empress' daily life was recorded in Qi Ju Zhu. The Empress Dowager Xiao Ding tracked Qi Ju Zhu. Wan Li had to admit he had a relationship with Wang Shi. In 1582, under the pressure of the Empress Dowager Xiao Ding, Wan Li had to promote Wang Shi to Consort Gong. In August of the same year, Consort Gong gave birth Wan Li's first son, Zhu Changluo, known as the Emperor Guangzong of Ming. 2 years later, Consort Gong gave birth Wan Li's fourth daughter, the Princess Yunmeng. Unfortunately, this little princess didn't grow up. She died when she was 3 years old. Although Consort Gong gave birth two kids for Wan Li, this didn't mean Wan Li liked her. In 1582, Wan Li met his true love Zheng Wengjing, known as the noble consort Zheng. 4 years later, the noble consort Zheng gave birth Wan Li's third son, Zhu Changxun, who was actually the second son. Wan Li immediately promoted the noble consort Zheng to the imperial noble consort. To please the noble consort Zheng, Wan Li continually tried to promote Zhu Changxun as the crown prince, which was obeyed the inheritance system of Ming. When the Emperor Hongwu found the Ming, he regulated that the Emperor's son had priority to inherit the throne. If the Empress didn't have son, the throne should be passed to the consort's oldest son. Wan Li's Empress didn't have son, so, according to the rule, the throne should be passed to Consort Gong's son, Zhu Changluo. Because of the throne competition, Wan Li and the noble Consort Zheng really hated Consort Gong and her son. They continually bullied those poor mother and son. The noble Consort Zheng false accused Zhu Changluo several times, but didn't succeed. In 1601, under the high pressure from the ministers and the Empress Dowager Xiao Ding, Wan Li had to promote Zhu Changluo to the crown prince. Zhu Changluo left her mother and lived in Qiqing Palace and wasn't allowed to visit her mother again. 5 years later, Zhu Changluo had his first son. To celebrate the birth of this little prince, Wan Li had to promote Consort Gong to the imperial noble consort. In 1611, Consort Gong was dying. Zhu Changluo begged his father, Wan Li, to allow him to visit his mother. When Zhu Changluo came to his mother's residential palace, he found her mother's residential palace was locked. Zhu Changluo broke the lock and came to her mother's room. At that time, Consort Gong was already planned. She used her hands to touch Zhu Changluo's face and said, "My son grow up, I can die." Then Consort Gong passed away. After birth, Consort Gong was harshly buried. Wan Li only gave her a little funerary items. In 1620, Zhu Changluo became the emperor. He immediately posthumously promoted her mother to the empress. 1 month became the emperor, Zhu Changluo passed away. Consort Gong's grandson became the emperor, known as the Emperor Xizong of Ming. The Emperor Xizong reburied Consort Gong into Wan Li's tomb in Dingling and added 3 boxes treasures as her funerary items. In 1958, Dingling was dug by the researchers. Xiao Jing's 2 extremely beautiful crowns were found. Now, people know those crowns were belonged to the Empress Xiao Jing, but rarely know the Empress Xiao Jing had an extremely difficult life when she was alive and had no chance to wear those valuable crowns. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.